Hello students, this is Dr. A. S. Iyer. I welcome you all for the course on Mechanics of Solids. I have started lecture series on this course, Mechanics of Solids, because this is the fundamental subject which is used in many engineering disciplines, especially in civil engineering, structural engineering, mechanical engineering and aerospace engineering. And the analysis and design of the civil, mechanical and aerospace structures is fundamentally depend on the concepts of mechanics of solids. So it's very important for civil, mechanical and aerospace engineers to understand the fundamental concepts of mechanics of solids. And in this lecture series, I will try to explain all those fundamental concepts, right? So today, in this first lecture, we'll discuss about what is mechanics of solids. Okay. So mechanics of solids is also known with some other titles in the literature. That is mechanics of materials, strength of materials, solid mechanics, and mechanics of deformable bodies. So you may find some books in the literature of this title, which is nothing but mechanics of solids. But from my side, I would like to suggest that the best book on mechanics of solids or mechanics of material, which is available in the literature to understand the concepts, conceptual part of mechanics of solids. And that book is of title Mechanics of Material, written by James Gray and Stephen Timoshenko. This is one of the best book available in the literature if you want to understand mechanics of solids conceptually. And we should not forget the contribution of Professor Stephen Timoshenko in the development of engineering mechanics as well as strength of material, which is also called as mechanics of solids. He is a great professor, philosopher who contributed a lot in the engineering mechanics. Stephen Timoshenko was a Russian actually. Now it is in, he born in Russian territory, which is in now in Ukraine. He was engineer as well as academician. Finally, he stayed in United States. And because of his contribution, he is considered to be the father of modern engineering mechanics. Right? He was professor in Stanford University, USA. And he wrote many books on the mechanics of solids or engineering mechanics, theory of elasticity, theory of plates and shell. These books are still used by many teachers, professors, researchers to understand the basic concepts of mechanics of solids, elasticity and strength of material. Now, what is mechanics of solids? We know that we already learned in the first year engineering. Engineering mechanics. In engineering mechanics, we are dealing with the forces which are acting on a body. So we are studying about a force, effect of a force on a rigid body in engineering mechanics. So rigid body means the body which will not undergo any deformation even after the application of external pressure or external force. It means if you apply a force on any body and still if there is no deformation in that body, you can call it as a rigid body. So in engineering mechanics, it is assumed that body is a rigid body, and that's why there is no study related to the body in engineering mechanics. We are studying about only forces. So what is the system of force applied on a body? What is the resultant of that force? What is the equilibrium of that force? Okay, so we are studying about the effects of force on a body. What happened to that body is not a part of engineering mechanics, because we assume in engineering mechanics the body is a rigid body. Rigid body means, again I repeat, there is no deformation in the body even after application of external pressure or force. Right? But in mechanics of solids, we have to study the effects of a force on a deformable body. Deformable body means the body which undergoes the deformation because of application of external pressure or external force. For example, if you take a rubber ball, if you press that rubber ball, it will deform. If you take a rod, if you try to bend it, it will bend. So the body which undergoes a deformation after the application of force is called as deformable body, right? And when you study the effect of force on such deformable bodies, that is called as mechanics of solids. So this is the basic difference between engineering mechanics and mechanics of solids. In engineering mechanics, we are studying the effect of force on a rigid body, right? And in mechanics of solids, we are studying effects of force on a deformable body. Rigid body means there is no deformation in the body even after application of forces. But in deformable body, there is a deformation in the body when it is subjected to external forces or external pressure. Okay. Now, why this study of mechanics of solid is necessary? The principal objective of mechanics of solid is to determine stresses, strains, and deformation in the structure due to the load acting on them. So when any structure, it may be civil engineering structure, it may be mechanical machines or system, or it may be aeroplane, aircraft means aerospace structures. So any structure when it is subjected to load, what are the values of stresses, strain and deformation in that body? When you determine these three quantities, this is nothing but studying the mechanics of solids. Now, why these quantities are important? These stresses, strain and deformation. These quantities, if you know, if you find out these quantities, it will give you complete picture about the mechanical behavior of the structure. When you are estimating stresses, strains and deformation, it means you will be able to understand what is mechanical behavior of that structure. Why this mechanical behavior is important? Because if you understand the mechanical behavior of any structure, then only you will be able to provide the safe design of that structure. So, to design any structure considering its safety, okay, so to provide the safe design of any structure, if you understand what is the mechanical behavior of that structure when it is subjected to load, then only it is possible that to provide the safe design. And when, how to understand the mechanical behavior? To understand the mechanical behavior, you must know the stresses, strains and deformation of that structure when it is subjected to the forces. So this is why the mechanics of solid is important, and this is what the principal objective of mechanics of solid, to determine the stresses, strain and displacement in a body, deformable body, when it is subjected to loads. Okay, so this is about the fundamental part, means what is mechanics of solids and what is the difference between engineering mechanics and mechanics of solids. In the next class, we will start with the first module of this course. Okay, that is what is stress, what is strain, and all those fundamental parts. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.